From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. The Maine Department of Transportation has shut down a bridge northbound on Washington Street in Auburn, all because of flooding. Officials say the current from the Little Androscoggin River is moving very quickly under the bridge and flooding a nearby neighborhood. The DOT is concerned about debris collecting on the bridge, but says there is no structural damage. In Falmouth, the DOT says the Lambert Bridge on Blackstep Road could be closed indefinitely as engineers wait to inspect that bridge. Now, the price tag to repair the fire-damaged nuclear submarine in Kittery is estimated to be about $400 million. Maine Congresswoman Shelley Pingree released the estimate today, a day after seeing damage firsthand inside the USS Miami. The sub was in dry dock at Portsmouth Naval Shipyard when the fire broke out back on May 23rd. Pingree says that number could change. She says she is optimistic, though, that the sub can be repaired. A prosecutor say an arrest has been made in an Arundel Credit Union robbery from last week. Investigators have charged 30-year-old Travis Lehman for holding up the Infinity Credit Union last Tuesday. They say he stole more than $7,600 at gunpoint. Lehman now faces a federal bank robbery charge. And police in two states say they think the same woman is behind two bank robberies. Investigators say back in May, this woman right here held up the Bank of New Hampshire in Conway. Then, just days later, on May 29th, she also robbed the Kennebunk Savings Bank in York. Investigators in both York and in Conway are asking for the public's help in identifying the robber. No one was hurt in either of those robberies, and you're asked to contact either the York or Conway, New Hampshire police. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.